All right, welcome back to OU Nightly. Thanks for joining us. It's been a busy weather day here in Oklahoma. Let's get right to it. We've got plenty to cover here. 68 degrees out there now. Taking a look at some partly cloudy skies. Looking really good out there. Those winds, they are howling out of the south. We are dry. This is going to change as we go throughout the next couple of days. Again, winds are gusting. They are all over the place here. 30 to 40 miles per hour just here in the metro. Just recorded a 45 mile per hour wind gust out in Fort Cobb. This combined with the dry conditions, the dormant vegetation is leading to a fire risk all across the state. That's much of the same. Again, wind gusts from 20 to 30 to 40 to now even 50 miles per hour all across the state of Oklahoma. This has led to a wind advisory. This is now in effect through the end of this evening before we gear up. We get ready for more winter weather as we head into the next couple of days here. So we're talking about lots of different conditions going on up there right now. We've got our next storm system out here over California. This is bringing the jet stream up across Oklahoma. This next front will push down as we go throughout the next couple of days. This is going to bring a risk for some severe weather. So Hannah Gard is going to take a look here at your severe weather risk as we continue now into the next couple of days.
Yeah, guys, we are looking at our storm zone here. Most of Oklahoma included in this slight risk for severe weather, and most of the state included in any risk at all. So what we're looking at with timing here for this severe weather tomorrow, if we time this out and we take a look at our radar, this cold front is going to start to move in tomorrow afternoon. We'll see that moving into the panhandle, some spotty showers popping up, and then as we head into Thursday morning, this is going to be very early on Thursday, so be aware of this overnight into Thursday. We'll see a line of storms start to form here. So the tornado zone, once those storms get down into the southern part of the state, that's when the greatest threat for tornadoes is going to be. We're also looking at another hail threat, and that's going to be for most of central and southern Oklahoma. We could see up to golf ball sized hail in some places. Let's take a look at those risks. Our main risks are really going to be that wind and hail. We'd still have that low tornado threat, but once again, if we have 60 to 80 mile per hour wind gusts with those severe storms and we see fairly large hailstones, we could definitely see that damage with that we have seen earlier this year. But coming up, we're gonna have more from Colton. Let's take a look at that snowfall chance.
That's right, Hannah. So as we take a look here, as we head into the overnight hours, once the severe storms roll through on Thursday morning, then the cold front will advance behind them. And this is the point where we'll have to start watching for the potential for some winter weather. So as we go ahead, we play out our radar here. You see now as we're heading into Thursday, 8 a.m., you see now the cold front has passed through. The storms have made their way through. And now we're in a changeover period where we're now going from heavy cold rain to a winter mix and snow even as we head into Thursday morning. This has the potential to last all the way through Thursday afternoon. So again, as we take a look into our now our watches and warnings, now there is a winter storm watch in effect for the far northern and northwestern parts of Oklahoma. That will end or that will go into effect tomorrow night all the way through Thursday evening. And then as we take a look now at our timings here, so overnight Wednesday, 100% chance. This is now for our severe storms. Again, this is overnight Wednesday and into Thursday here. And then as we take a look into Thursday morning, now we're talking about snow again as it changes over here Thursday morning, a winter mix here for much of central Oklahoma, and then the far south and southeast is where we'll see the potential for those severe storms. So taking a look at snowfall totals, we really expect this to change over the next day or so as we take a look at when this cold front arrives. Right now for the Oklahoma City metro, we're looking anywhere between a trace to 1 to 2 inches. The greatest snow totals have the potential to be in the far north. So back to this evening, talking about this evening, we've got upper 60s, really a great evening this evening to get out there to enjoy the weather. By 7 o'clock, you'll be in the lower 60s. We'll dip down into the upper 50s by 9 o'clock, but before we have lower 50s for lower 50s, upper 40s for our lows tonight. We will be very much above average tonight, and then tomorrow again, really a five-star day coming up tomorrow. Upper 60s, lower 70s all across Oklahoma, even middle to upper 70s in the western and the southwest. And then again, as we look to tomorrow, really looking good before we start that 70% chance rolls in tomorrow night. Before Thursday morning, we have a 100% chance. And then as we head into this weekend, we look really good before our next cold front arrives early next week.